We see patient after patient who's gone through PGS at other centers maybe produce 10, 12 embryos and not had any transferred because they were told they're all abnormal. At CHR, we choose to take another approach. We are not encouraging our patients to do preimplantation genetic screening of their embryos for aneuploidy because we're not convinced that the technique is going to give us a fair representation of the embryo, of the whole embryo. And we believe that, and have evidence to, that supports the idea that even though a biopsy may appear to be abnormal, you may still end up with a normal baby. One of the really disappointing things that happened to some patients at other centers is that using techniques like so-called mini IVF, they will go through a series of stimulations, retrievals, producing an embryo, and then cryopreservation of that embryo. And the notion there is that their plan is to produce, you know, one embryo this month, maybe one embryo next month, maybe two, and then over a course of 5 or 6 months, they have, 5 to 8 embryos. And then after all that's done, they then thaw all the embryos and do preimplantation genetic screening. And too many times we've seen patients who've gone through all of that, and it may take a year to do 6 cycles, who then are told all their embryos are abnormal and they can't have a transfer. We think that this is not really fair to the patients. What we would do in that circumstance would be to do a transfer in each cycle. If the embryo is good, it's going to grow, become a baby, and save you from the other 6 cycles. The goal here is not to go through a bunch of cycles. The goal here is to have a normal pregnancy. And we think the less manipulation we do to the embryos, the greater chance our patients would have of having a normal pregnancy.